that feeling when you're stuck at a red light and no one's coming. You're waiting there for hours, staring at an empty road. While a few blocks away, cars are backed up for miles. Because the traffic lights doesn't know what's happening in real time. And you might think, we have developed self-driving cars. But somehow, our traffic lights are still stuck in the 1980s. That's funny, right? But that can also be a clue, because it shows how we have spent so much time asking how smart technology can get. Maybe it's time we start asking how caring technology can become, because true intelligence, that is real wisdom, is not about speed or data. It's about understanding what truly matters. Take that traffic light again. For decades, traffic lights have been run on fixed timers, programmed long ago, and they never adapt to real conditions. But that's changing. Cities around the world are using AI-powered traffic lights that can actually adapt according to the real-time conditions. So when you're sitting at a red light, staring at an empty road, the light changes to green faster, and when a jam starts to build across the road, the traffic lights are able to spot it early and adjust the timers accordingly so that everything is running smoothly. In cities like Phoenix and Tucson, these AI-powered traffic systems have cut down waiting times by half and also cut down the red light violations by 70% and the fuel cost by millions. That's the artificial intelligence that saves time. It makes our lives easier, smoother and more efficient. But just one step ahead is the artificial intelligence that saves lives. Now imagine this. A self-driving car glides down a quiet street. Everything's perfect. Sensors humming, traffic light flowing smoothly. Then suddenly, a child runs into the road chasing after a ball. Now, there is no time to ask a person what to do. The car has to decide. Brake, swerve, sacrifice. That's the point when AI stops being about algorithms. It starts becoming about values. It's not about can AI think fast, but it's about can AI care enough and choose with empathy. That's where the real test of intelligence begins. And we're already seeing the shift happening in the real world. AI-powered drones can be used in places affected by natural disasters like landslides, floods, and earthquakes. They can be used to spot survivors by scanning the terrain, and they can also be used to deliver food and medical supplies to places where roads are blocked. What used to take hours by foot can now be done within minutes. So every minute saved is equal to a life being saved. And now we are using AI not only to respond to disasters, but also to predict them by using systems that monitor rainfall, soil movement, and heat patterns. This data can be used to warn communities even before the tragedy strikes. This is quite a revolution. AI is not only learning to solve problems, but also to prevent pain. And this same idea, AI that helps when it truly matters, is transforming healthcare too. For years, doctors have been our heroes, scanning medical images and spotting the faintest shadows of diseases. But even the best human eye can miss what's invisible. And now, AI systems can analyze medical scans and detect hidden patterns even before the symptoms ever appear. These systems are not here to replace doctors, but to empower them by offering them more time and giving them more hope. During the pandemic, AI systems helped hospitals predict shortages, optimize routes, and get supplies to places where it was needed the most. This was not just smart technology, this was wisdom in action. And today, doctors are able to create digital twins, that is, virtual models of our bodies to test treatments and also rehearse surgeries even before touching the real patient. This is precision, but also it is compassion backed by innovation. Still, there is one constant challenge: information overload. Every day, hospitals generate thousands of medical scans and test results. Hidden in that data can be one clue that changes everything. And AI systems are able to find that one clue. AI systems are able to detect early signs of tumors, heart diseases, and cancer. And these systems are not here to replace doctors, but to empower them so that they can do a better job in saving lives. That's the kind of intelligence that feels human. And this goes beyond hospitals. Picture a crowded concert. Music blasting, energy surging, people moving. And suddenly, people began to push and panic starts to build. But what if an AI system watching from above detected the danger even before everyone else did? And what if it sent a soft alert? Please move slightly right. Safety risk detected. One small message, hundreds of lives saved, or even thousands of lives saved. That's not flashy, that's not trending, but that's what real progress looks like. The real success is invisible because the disaster never happened. And that's what connects all these stories. AI-powered traffic lights, self-driving cars, drones, hospitals, and crowds. They all remind us that AI isn't about replacing humans. It's about amplifying humanity. That's what I call a thoughtful AI design. Technology that not only thinks, but it cares. Because if AI can prevent suffering, extend life, or even make someone feel seen, it's not just innovation, it's humanity encoded. We spend so much time asking, can AI do what humans can do? But maybe it's time we ask, can AI really help humans become better versions of themselves? Because someday, the most successful AI won't be the ones that beats us at chess or writes a perfect poem, but the ones that quietly saves life or even helps a doctor deliver good news instead of bad. And the most beautiful part, those victories won't make headlines. They'll happen quietly in hospitals, in cities, and in homes. Because the true measure of AI success is not how much it knows, but how much it cares. Thank you.